Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel, which is dedicated to teaching you mathematics according to the Zambian syllabus. Like I said, we're concentrating on grade 10 up to 12 mathematics first, before we look at other grades. Those of you that are writing GCE, you know that in most cases you have got complications. Going to class, please make sure that you get glued to this channel because it is meant to help you pass mathematics. You don't want to be rewriting over and over. That is why I'm promising that I'm going to give you the best. Even those people that are going to school, this channel is there for you. It is as good as you going to class, but that does not mean you should go and you should abscond class, or you should go and disrespect your teachers because they are going to come and attend your lessons from this channel. That would be quite unfortunate and regrettable. I do not expect such a thing to happen. All I would want is you to make sure that you are comparing the concepts and where things are happening. Okay? That is, humility is very key, and respect is always cardinal for anything that you are doing in life. Alright? So we have to make sure that even as pupils, we may have additional places where we go for tuitions and the channels such as this one. Those do not mean we should stand up in arms with our teachers. That would quite disrespectful of you. Alright? Otherwise, once again, welcome to my channel, where we are committed to helping people change the narrative of mathematics. Alright? I'm going to look at the matrices. It's a grade 10 topic according to our syllabus, and there are subtopics there that are supposed to be handled. Okay, so in today's lesson, I have just decided to introduce the topic and look at a transpose. That's all. So what is a matrix? What is a matrix? You're going to look at a number of definitions in matrix. You'll find a lot, but the simplified one is a matrix is a rectangular array of numbers. It's a rectangular array of numbers. We've got rows and columns. A matrix is a rectangular array of numbers. It is okay. These numbers, we call them elements, those numbers that are in the matrix. So the example of a matrix is this one. The example of a matrix is this one. This is a matrix, a rectangular array of a number. Numbers are put in an order such that they form something like a rectangle. That's why we are calling it a rectangular array of numbers. So this is a matrix, and this is the topic that we're going to deal with, okay, in the next series of presentations. All right, so this is a rectangular array of numbers. Okay, so in a matrix, we have rows and columns. We have rows and columns. So for rows, these are horizontal, I will call it a horizontal line of numbers. So the first one, this order of numbers that are in a horizontal line, these are called rows. These, so we have got one row, the second row, the third row, just like that. Then these ones are columns, okay? These ones are columns. So when we want to determine the order of a matrix, we start with the rows. These ones, the horizontal lines of numbers, okay? So in this case, we are looking at, when we're talking about to determine, when we want to determine the order of a matrix, we are looking at how many rows are there multiplied, or how many rows are there and how many columns are there. So basically how we present the order of a matrix is as the number of rows, which is in this case 2, by the number of columns that this matrix does have, which is also 2. It could also be 2 by 2. This is the order of a matrix. This is the order of a matrix. So, should we have a change to this, then we are saying, if we have something like okay, let's look at this one. How many rows do we have here? I said rows, it's this horizontal line or order of numbers. This one, so this is one row, this is the second row. So in this case, we've got two rows multiplied by how many columns? The columns we have, 1, 2, 3. So we've got 3 columns. So this is the order of this matrix. The order of this matrix. Okay? The same applies to, if we can look at something like, the order of this matrix. The order of this matrix, how many rows do we have? We have the first row, second row, and the third row. In the columns, we only have one. So the order is 3. So this means we have 3 rows and the 1 column. Okay? So basically, this is the, that has to be emphasized in the introductory part. When it comes to the examinations in grade 9 exam, that's where they ask you to state the order of the matrix. But as for grade 10s upwards, we mentioned them just for introductory purposes, all right? Otherwise, they are not examinable as a standalone question. So, I want us to look at a transpose of a matrix. How do we transpose a matrix? How do we transpose a matrix? So, how do we transpose a matrix? Okay. So, if we have a matrix such as A, A is 3, 4, maybe 5, and 0, 6, 2. If this is our A, this matrix is called A, then what is the transpose of A? The transpose of A is also denoted as, it's denoted by this letter, okay, 2 square, T, A is written to the power T there, so this is the transpose of this matrix. So if the question comes as in, given that A is equals to this matrix, then find this thing as it is written here. Then we are asking you to find the transpose of this matrix. So how do we find the transpose of a matrix? So to transpose this matrix, to transpose a matrix, we are going to change rows or become columns, and then columns become rows. That is a transpose. We have transposed. Okay? The rows, so it's like the order changes, like I was stating there. The order changes. Okay? The order of this one is what? 2 by 3. Now, when we transpose it, our order will change to 3 by 2. So what we are saying is that to transpose a matrix, the order, the rows become the columns, then the columns become rows. So like here, our first row is this one, so we'll write this as, it will become a first column. So have 3, 4, and 5. Our second row is this one, and it will come out, it will become our second column. So it will be, this is the transpose of our matrix. Such questions do come in grade 12 exam, paper 1. Okay? Such questions do come. You can refer to them. You've got an app that you can download that has got the past papers for ECZ and to help you. You are going to find such questions. And also, in the same manner, if they ask you to say a transpose of A is this one, then find the original matrix. You're doing the opposite. You're reversing this back to that. Okay? Because sometimes I would ask questions in that manner. Alright. So given that transpose is this, given that A is this one, and find the transpose, this is what you get to be your transpose. And then if the transpose is what is given, then they want the origin. You do the same thing. Okay? You do the same thing. We're actually going to get it. This one becomes our first row, then this one becomes our second row. So that's that about the transpose. Transpose of a matrix. Transpose of matrix. Transpose of a matrix. Okay? So let's try to transpose a second matrix. Maybe we do the opposite, like I was telling you, the way sometimes questions do come in the exam. It would be something like, given that P is equals to 7, 8, 2. Then find P. Okay? Here we have been given the transpose, then we want to find P. So it will be the reverse of this one. Okay? It will be the reverse of this one. So P, our matrix P, is going to be 7, 8, and 2. Okay? This is a matrix. Make sure, please don't make a mistake to start putting commas here. No, this is a matrix. So this is a transpose of a matrix. I mean, this is the original matrix that was transposed to give birth to this one. All right. So this is all you needed to know about the transpose. And this was just an introduction of matrices according to the syllabus that we are confining ourselves to, that is the Zambian syllabus in preparation for the grade 12 exams, GCE and the internal exam. So try to transpose the following. You can try to transpose the following. Try to transpose the following. Right, transpose the following. So you can try this one. Transpose the following. Matrices. First one we have 4, 7, 8. 0. Then B, we have A, B, C, X, Y, minus Z. Okay? This is what is going to be your exercise. And we are talking about matrices, this to be transformed, to be transposed. Alright, matrices is a plural word. If we are talking about one, it's a matrix. It's a matrix. If we are talking about one, it's a matrix. Alright. Thank you so much for watching. I hope these things are making sense and they are helping us to prepare ourselves for the exam. I'm going to be at your service until you write your exams. Please continue to invite people to subscribe to this channel. The more you are, the better, in order to do it together. Thank you very much. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Leave a comment so that we can improve on how to deliver the lessons to you. Until next time.